The doctors want government to fulfill more than 500 vacant posts in the public health facilities, fulfill the presidential directive of increasing their salaries with a starting medical worker earning 5 million shillings and above, consultant doctors earning 17 million shillings monthly, among others. Speaking to journalists today in Kampala, the medical workers under the umbrella body, Uganda Medical Association, said they are tired of being lied to. They say in 2017 the president directed that their salaries be increased, but up to now nothing has been done apart from the continued empty promises.
This is chronological. This is how patient doctors can be. We've been patient since 2017. The presidential directive was implemented partially in 2019, never fulfilled. So we are saying no, enough is enough. Look at restocking the health facilities with consumables and drugs. Look at employing doctors all over the whole country. We have a 554 gap, which is just lacking. Vacant positions, unoccupied.
They are also bothered by the failure by government to compensate the families of their colleagues who succumbed to COVID-19 while on duty. They want this worked on, including providing medical supplies in hospitals, such as medical and putting up ICU units in the national and regional hospitals. These aggrieved workers have vowed not to step in hospitals again if government continues failing to fulfill their promises.
And today, at 00 hours, midnight, as the president of Uganda Medical Association, I call upon all doctors countrywide to lay down their tools until government takes this as a serious event.
The over 1,000 medical workers have today joined the intern doctors who already laid down tools over poor pay. The intern doctors are demanding that they be included in the public service salary structure and their salaries be increased to 2.5 million monthly as directed by the president.
On the 17th of May this year, medical interns nationwide went on a sit-down strike to demand improved welfare, with key issues being that medical interns are not housed and therefore end up dwelling in unsafe accommodations, the daily transport costs that medical interns couldn't afford given the little pay that we receive. Medical interns were not provided with meals and yet stay far from hospitals and are expected to provide care 24/7, something that didn't go well with the medical interns and caused them to go on a sit-down strike in May.
When we consulted Minister of Health for a comment over the matter, they said they were not aware of any industrial action by the doctors.
Abasawo baffe mbakubiriza babere bagumikiriza ebitongole bingi bya government ngo twalizemu ne ministry y'ebyobulamu. Tuni mukukola kulaba nti zino sente zivayo tusasule abasawo nga president bwe yaragira. So eno process kateri before parliament okulaba nti okusaba kwa supplementary eyetagisibwa okulaba nti esente zongerwako z'abasawo kiteekwa mu nkola. So tulinze ebinaava mu parliament ne finance.
Whatever the case, it remains to be seen whether government will respond to their demands and avoid the effects such a strike might have on the country's health system in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic and the ongoing medical interns strike. Story by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.